YouTube, I'm Ebony. Welcome back to my channel. We are at Vlogmas day 7. I am extremely exhausted, but I am also proud of myself for still continuing and recording every single day and showing up. So that counts for something. I wanted to make my video today about mindset tips for mompreneurs. I know it's very difficult to keep going and to not give up when things don't go your way. So I wanted to give some tips to just help any of you out there. Mamas, I know you need it, and I'm about to hook y'all up today. Before we get started, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please subscribe and also hit that notification bell to be notified when I upload a new video for you guys. So let's get started. The first tip I would like to share with you would be keep a positive mindset. It's easier said than done, but realize that your mind is so powerful and it basically will go off of anything that you're thinking. So you have to keep it positive. Things aren't always going to be easy. You have to be completely kind and patient with yourself. You should be aware that you're not going to know every single answer. You're not going to know which route to take each and every time. A way that I feel has helped me to keep a positive mindset is I do daily affirmations. At first, it just sounded like it was just stuff that I was telling myself, but consistency is key. Once I continue to tell myself this over and over and over again, it's already embedded in me. So my mind, body, and soul, everything is already going with what I'm telling myself every single day with these affirmations. I know them to the point in the back of my head where I don't have to even look at them anymore, but I realize that I have to still say these because everything that you're telling yourself, you have to continue to reiterate and confirm to yourself that you're doing the right thing and you're on the right track, and just keep that positive mindset will get you going to the next step. Another mindset tip. When things aren't going your way, or things don't go as planned, issues occur, you get knocked down, just the inevitable that's going to happen during your process as an entrepreneur. Something that has honestly worked for me is instead of dwelling on the bad and what has happened that didn't go my way, I look at the positives and say to myself, well, at least this went well, or that's okay. You have to be okay with things not going as planned, and then that's when you have to brainstorm and go a different route. What I've noticed is that it's all about timing. So something that you may have planned to go your way and it didn't go as planned, you have to look at it as in, oh, not that you failed, but also that wasn't yours, that wasn't meant to be, that wasn't your route to take. Whatever is going to happen literally is already in the plan for you, and it's going to happen. Whatever answer you're supposed to get, whatever questions you need to ask, everything is going to come together and work out to serve you. So look at things in the positive way. When you look at them in more of the positive way, you're not getting so consumed in everything that can go wrong, everything that's already going wrong, because you're getting away from all the good things that have happened. Another tip that has been really helpful for me is becoming aware of what you're thinking and watching your thoughts. Stay away from negativity. Be conscious of your thoughts and what you're thinking. Things that can help you stay away from negative thoughts is just staying busy. Avoid triggers that can get you back to old patterns, procrastination, putting things off, not doing exactly what you want to do, staying away from negative people and their perception of things, their feedback, their opinions of things that can get you off track. And that can be very discouraging, especially when you have ideas and things that you want to do in life and people are tearing you down. This next tip that I'm going to share with you, I think, is one of the most extremely important tips that you need to know, and that is to just believe in yourself and believe in everything that you're going after. Believing that you're capable, believing that it's not impossible, believing that you're good enough, believing that you deserve it, is all things that are going to get you to where you want to be. They're going to continue to keep you moving forward. They're going to keep you in that mindset to just go after everything you want because you're believing that it's possible. You're believing it. Once you believe it, you know, they say that, oh, I don't believe until I see it. But it's the opposite. You have to believe it before you see it. When you believe it, then that's when everything that you're believing comes into fruition because you're constantly working on it. You're constantly trying to better yourself. You're constantly working towards your goals. So you have to believe in yourself. You have to believe in the goal. You have to believe that you're capable, and you definitely have to believe that you're worth it. Are you ready for another tip? Are you sure? Are you sure? Practice being your future self. It's important to completely reprogram your past story. Whoever you were before, it no longer matters. It's all about being your future self. It's all about aligning with your true values and what you stand for. I'm a certified health and life coach. Yes, I know the ins and outs of being a health coach, but am I the healthiest person on the planet? Absolutely not. So I felt that I related more on the life side because I have a lot of experience and I am more relatable and I'm living my life for what I'm actually teaching in my programs. So when I was a health coach, it didn't come off as genuine and it was so forced because I wasn't living that life. And then that's where it comes into the term imposter syndrome. I didn't want to be helping people with this perfect diet or eating healthy or doing all these things that I wasn't living that. I don't feel that that's right for me specifically. So I feel like you need to start to align yourself with the person that you are wanting to become. So get rid of that past story that you've been telling yourself and everyone else and start living that future self that you want to be and who you will be. Another mindset tip would be finding support. So sometimes, majority of the time, we know what we need to do, we just don't always do it. So sometimes preparing or having a conversation with someone to get you mentally ready to do the things that you need to do, to get that motivation, to get that oomph that you need to just keep pushing, that's what you need to do. Sometimes just having that conversation before you need to get certain things done or a task that you need to complete, it can be very helpful. I have a accountability partner, and sometimes even today, we're all human. I was very busy. You know, you just got so much stuff going on, and sometimes you just don't feel like doing stuff. So just speaking with my accountability partner, she was just walking me through, just giving me words of encouragement, words of inspiration, letting me know that I'm doing the right things. It just motivated me to just get on track and do exactly what I know that I needed to do already. So sometimes just having that extra support, that extra person helping you can change your mindset and to get you from I don't feel like it to all right, I'm about to do this. So definitely find support if you're able to find support, no matter whether it's a family member, an accountability partner, whether it's someone in a Facebook group. Facebook groups are very, very, very helpful, and they have plenty of people, like-minded people, entrepreneurs who are grinding just like you are, who can help you and inspire you. And this can hold you accountable to get things done that you need to get done, for the fact that sometimes mentally you're just drained, mentally you just don't want to do it, but you know that's what you need to do. So it's extremely helpful and it works. Now go get that support. The last mindset tip that I would like to share with you would be to remember why you started. Remember why you're doing this. I don't know if you need to have it written down so that you can go back and refer to it, or just whatever way would be best for you specifically to remember why you started. This will give you so much inspiration. This will just remind you of just why you're going so hard, why you're so tired, why you're so exhausted, why you want to give up. But it's all for this specific reason. Me personally, I don't like working for other people. I don't like having a schedule that someone else is telling me that I need to have. I like to be on my own time. I like to just do things my own way. I want to build for my family. I want to have something for them to fall back on. I just know what I want out of life for me, and this is why I go so hard, and it's for my babies. I want them to have the opportunities, not have to worry about money, be able to focus on whatever dreams that they have, but always have something to fall back on. You have to remember why you're starting this. Do not give up. It's gonna be so hard. Every single day is so hard. Every day you're not motivated. Every day you don't want to get up and do whatever you have to do for your business. But just remember that you're doing this for a specific reason. It's all going to pay off. You have to just keep on grinding and giving it your all. Mommies, what is your reason for continuing to go forward and to even start a business in the first place? Comment below on your motivation and what's inspiring you to even start a business. I hope these tips that I've shared with you today were helpful. I hope you're able to use them. I hope you're already using them. I just want to inspire you to just continue to go forward with your dreams. Do not give up. Remember, you are going against the grain. It's not going to be easy. This is not what society is telling us that we should be doing, so it's going to be harder. It's always easier to go with what we were already taught and told. But we don't want to live that life, and that's why we are building businesses and pushing so hard to get the things that we want as entrepreneurs. So let's just keep going. Let's be patient and kind to ourselves, and let's be supportive of each other, and let's just not give up and keep going and reach those goals that we are going so hard for and wanting to accomplish. This is the end of video 7. I will see you for tomorrow, Vlogmas day 8. We're getting there, y'all. We're getting there. See you tomorrow.